year. Proclamation, City of Melbourne, Florida. Whereas in 2012, a band called Sally's Hope, inspired by guitarist Andrew Derrick's mother Sally and her continuing cancer journey, released a debut album with 100% of the proceeds to be given away to those families impacted by cancer. And whereas after outstanding CD sales, band member Randy Walters says that the project was bigger than a band and needed an identity of its own. So he founded Give a Little Hope, Inc. in 2013, a local 501c3 nonprofit to help cancer-affected families find hope. And whereas Give a Little Hope, Inc. serves our local community by providing financial assistance in areas that other resources will not cover, including but not limited to co-pays, rent, utilities, gas money, and transportation, insurance premiums, hot meals, and hotel stays for treatments. And whereas Give a Little Hope, Inc. is a 100% volunteer organization and gives 100% of donated funds to the family or project chosen by the donor, unless unspecified. And whereas in early 2016, Give a Little Hope, Inc. will be establishing a cancer resource center for the South Brevard area, a one-stop shop for local, regional, and national cancer resources, providing funding options, answers to tough questions, list of local and regional oncologists, counselors, and support groups, and free screening to the most detectable cancers. Now, therefore, be it resolved that I, Kathleen H. Meehan, Mayor, City of Melbourne, Brevard County, Florida, do hereby recognize Give a Little Hope, Inc. for devoting its time and energy to raising funds for local cancer-affected families and encourage our citizens to support this worthwhile organization. Witness my hand and the seal of the City of Melbourne this 28th day of July, 2015.
Thank you so much for this awesome recognition. I'm going to tell you a little bit about Give a Little Hope. My name is Sally Derrick. I've been a Brevard County resident for 53 years. I am so proud to live in this great community. A few years ago, my world was rocked. I was diagnosed with pancreatic, spleen, and lung cancer, and was sent home basically to get the local hospice to come take care of me. Three kids at home and a husband I'm madly in love with, I said no. And we started this journey together. Being totally ignorant to how insurance works, I went to the Mayo Clinic and found out that I needed several extensive surgery and chemotherapy, and found out that I was out of network and insurance would only pay 40%. 40% of $500,000. My treatment would be $5,000 a week. Nobody could afford that. I had very little hope, and I felt unworthy of treatment. I wondered if I'd ever see my children get married. I wondered if I'd see my children graduate, birthdays, Christmas. It was a very dark time for me. My daughter, who was 8, made me pinky promise every morning that I wouldn't die while she was at school. I didn't know what to do. And that's where Give a Little Hope steps in. They're exactly what their name says. Give a little hope. Hope to a family in their darkest hour. Give a Little Hope provides meals. They pay electric bills. They buy birthday and Christmas presents. Your child can go on a field trip. Anything that you need. We've repaired cars for people. We provided rides. We pay co-pays. Anything that the family needs, we are there for them. The sad thing of this, my story is not alone. Every day in this great community, there are many brave heroes that are diagnosed every day and are facing the same battle that I am. And they are turned away by the large cancer charities that say the help we are denied because they fund for research. They do not help us with our co-pays, our birthdays, our gas, and keep our lights on. Give a Little Hope steps in and does all of that. And I am so grateful to be a part of this community. And being a cancer survivor continues this love to can help these families. They're your neighbors. They're your kids' teachers. They're the people in line beside you at the grocery store. We have great wigs, so you don't know that it's us. But we're out there, and we need your help. And that's where Give a Little Hope will bridge that the doctors will not accept courage, love, and hope as a payment, and that's what we have, but we need funds. So I'm honored to receive this award, but I am more honored that I'm able to serve this great community. Thank you so much.
Next will be